All right, welcome back to the Steve Gruber Show. Changing direction for a moment and talking about your health as we often do here. Looking at ways to make sure that, well, you get the most out of your life and remain healthy. Gordan Srkalovic is here, a medical oncologist, director of clinical trials at Sparrow's Herbert-Herman Cancer Center. Doctor, welcome to the program.
Thank you for having me here.
Now, I understand that you have been on the road a long way, and in fact, just delivered a lecture on preventing lung cancer to the Bosnian Academy of Arts and Sciences in Sarajevo. Now, here in America, I believe we still have 1,000 people a day that die from smoking-related illnesses. What would you share with the folks in Bosnia that you would share with the folks in America as well?
So I just delivered a lecture on preventing lung cancer to Bosnia Academy of Arts and Sciences in Sarajevo. And the main topic is really was smoking cessation or really exterminating smoking from our environment. 85% of lung cancers are directly caused by smoking, and the majority of those who are not directly related to secondhand smoking or indirect smoking. So in U.S., we achieved pretty good strides and success in reducing smoking. But still, as you said, there is a huge number of patients who die from smoking-related illnesses. In developing countries like Bosnia, it's an even bigger issue. This was part of my inauguration into Bosnian Academy of Arts and Sciences, and I am a 14 member of Academy who was born in Bosnia but live abroad.
Gotcha.
Who was admitted to this very prestigious institution.
Now, when you say that it's a bigger problem in developing countries like Bosnia, I know that here in the last few years, the number of Americans who smoke dropped below 20% for the first time in my lifetime. In fact, I was a smoker once, long, long ago. I quit back in 1999, June the 1st, if I was going to pick a date. So I guess I'm over the whole smoking thing 19 years on. My question to you is, what is the smoking rate in Bosnia? What are the smoking rates in other parts of the world apparently much higher?
So, yeah, it's a great question. And, you know, in a small country like Bosnia, has around 3.5 million, citizens, there is a half of them, almost half of them, who smokes.
Wow.
Smoke. So, which is interesting that even the rate of smoking among women is around over 40%. Even bigger problem is that close to 6 to 7% of children under 14 smokes.
That's
smoke, right?
That's frightening is what that is. Half of the people smoke, 40% of women, young people smoking. Here's my question. Obviously, the hazards of smoking have been known in the developed world for decades now, which is why, I mean, there's warnings on everything, and depending on what country you go to, you know, the warnings are bigger. In Canada, you can't even see cigarettes when you go and throw them behind a wall, and then the whole package is basically a black label warning you of the hazards of smoking. In America, lots of hazard warnings on the package. Well, do they have that in Bosnia and elsewhere?
So, yeah, that's another great question, and that's the main issue, because there is really very few restrictions. There is no warning labels on the packages. There is no government intervention into banning, actually, smoking from public places.
Wow.
And all the things that we achieve here with a lot of work and a lot of effort, they are just in the embryonal stage.
Sure, they're just getting started.
That was, yeah, right. That was the main reason I wanted to raise that question and really initiate some discussion and move country in the different direction.
Dr. Gordan Srkalovic here from Sparrow's Herbert-Herman Cancer Center, discussing the fact that a lot of people still smoke in this world without being warned about the dangers thereof. With you traveling to Bosnia there in Sarajevo to give that address, Does that speak to Sparrow's standing on the world stage when it comes to addressing cancer and cancer issues?
Definitely does. Sparrow's vision is to be recognized as a national leader in quality and patient experience, but there is a definite international flavor with staff and physicians from many countries throughout the world. And those physicians are very well recognized and very well respected in their own countries. So I think Sparrow is becoming recognized institution of high health and cancer care, not just in Michigan and in USA, but also internationally.
Certainly. Now, this is National Cancer Survivors Month is June. You can put me into that category. It's been a long time, but I had my scare with cancer when I was a teenager. Fortunately, I've come a long way since then, so I have a lot of empathy for those that battle the disease, and every one of us knows somebody who has had to battle cancer, or whether they won or lost, everybody knows somebody. We're all touched by cancer, I think it's fair to say, doctor. So the advancements, though, today, new every day, new technology, new opportunities to save people, to extend their lives, to promote a better quality of life. These things continue every day, don't they?
Absolutely, and with better treatment, better care, that army of cancer survivors is growing exponentially. And every year, people around the world celebrate life after cancer through National Cancer Survivor Month. And we really want to honor those who are living with history of cancer for their strength and courage. And we want to honor their families who are going through that, terrible experience.
Sure.
Which at the end created, longer life and better life for them.
A higher quality of life, a life worth living. You can find out more if you're interested by calling the Sparrow Herbert-Herman Cancer Center, 1-800-968-5570 or 517-364-9426. You can also go to sparrowcancer.org/ourservices/compassionatecare. Dr. Srkalovic, I greatly appreciate your time. Good conversation.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
My pleasure. Find out more at the Herbert-Herman Cancer Center at Sparrow Hospital. We'll be right back.